In continuation with the first video, we were studying process of oogenesis. So during growth and differentiation phase, which is a highly elaborate phase, many changes take place in nucleus and cytoplasm. So what are the main changes that take place in nucleus? Nucleus enlarges in size. Nucleus contains a fluid known as nucleoplasm. As more and more nucleoplasm is formed, so naturally nucleus enlarges in size, and now we call it as germinal vesicle. Nucleus contains nucleoli. Nucleoli, they also increase in number as more and more transcription of ribosomal RNA occurs from ribosomal DNA. This ribosomal DNA is present in nucleolar organizing region of chromosome. Then in some animals, particularly in amphibian oocytes, normal chromosomes, they change into giant chromosomes. One type of giant chromosomes, they are lamb brush chromosomes. So just see there, here I have shown you a small part of giant chromosome. These chromosomes, they are very large in size. Here the central axis, it has highly condensed DNA, but in some parts the DNA is stretched out to form loops. So these are loops of DNA. As DNA is uncoiled in this region, so naturally here more and more transcription of RNA can take place. So simply to increase the rate of transcription, because rate of transcription will be related to rate of protein synthesis. So this normal chromosomes in some oocytes changes into giant chromosomes. Then this large size nucleus, which is known as germinal vesicle, it shifts towards the animal pole of the oocyte, because during maturation phase polar bodies, they are to be formed. So polar bodies can easily, so that polar bodies can easily separate from the oocyte. So these are the changes in nucleus. What are the main changes that take place in cytoplasm? Cytoplasm increases in amount. Large number of ribosomes, they get assembled to form polyribosomes so as to start protein synthesis. Mitochondria, they increase in number. Mitochondria, they are, you know, they are capable of self-duplication. By undergoing self-duplication, they increase in number. Endoplasmic reticulum becomes more elaborate. Then rough endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi bodies, they form cortical granules. Cortical granules, they are made up of acid, mucopolysaccharides and proteins. These cortical granules, they are mainly assembled in the outer part of oocyte, which is known as cortex, and they will aid in fertilization, that we will cover in the chapter of fertilization. Then I have told you about mitochondria. Then primary oocyte has large amount of cell organelles, and cytoplasm is rich in RNA, ATP and enzymes. So intense protein synthesis takes place. Lipids and polysaccharides, they are also formed in large amount. Now these proteins and lipids, they get assembled in the form of yolk platelets. So it means laying down of yolk, which is made up of proteins and lipids, that occurs in the primary oocyte. This process is known as vitellogenesis. We will study this topic separately. It's there in your syllabus. So these are the changes that take place in the cytoplasm. Now I have written some important terms which may be asked in exam. First is discus proligerus, that I have told you that in a developing or mature Graafian follicle, what happens? Primary oocyte is surrounded by a few layers of follicular cells, which are known as discus proligerus. Then what is cumulus oophorus or germ hill? Then in a mature Graafian follicle, there is a stalk of follicular cells that attaches discus proligerus with the follicular wall, which is known as cumulus oophorus. Then the release of ovum from the oocyte, or from mature, release of ovum or oocyte from the mature follicle is known as ovulation. Then after the release of ovum, oocyte, the empty Graafian follicle develops a yellow endocrine gland. That endocrine gland is known as corpus luteum. But if fertilization does not take place, then this corpus luteum reduces into a non-functional whitish body, which is known as corpus albicans. Now here just see, in longitudinal section of ovary, these were the developing stages of Graafian follicle. This step shows release of ovum from the Graafian follicle, that is ovulation. After the ovulation, Graafian follicle is left with a yellow colored fluid, which is known as corpus luteum. So if fertilization does not take place, this corpus luteum reduces into a whitish body, which is non-functional. This whitish non-functional body is known as corpus albicans. So here in this section also, these stages, they have been shown. So this is regarding the process of oogenesis. So egg oogenesis is contributing haploid maternal set of chromosomes in the form of egg. Besides this, egg is storing large amount of yolk, food for the development of the embryo. So this is the, you can say, significance of oogenesis.